It is very important to know that every righteous deed that a person does may be part of that with which Allah will cause the balance of his good deeds to weigh heavily on the day of resurrection. Allah, may he be exalted, says. Interpretation of the meaning. Indeed, Allah does not do injustice, even as much as an atom's weight. While if there is a good deed, he multiplies it and gives from himself a great reward. So whoever does an atom's weight of good will see it. And whoever does an atom's weight of evil will see it. There are texts which speak of specific deeds which will weigh particularly heavy in the doers. Balance on the day of resurrection. These include the following. 1. Talil, or saying La ilaha illallah, none has the right to be worshipped but Allah. This is the deed that will weigh most heavily in the balance. It was narrated that Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will bring forth a man belonging to my ummah, before all creatures and will spread 99 scrolls. Containing the record of his bad deeds, for him each scroll extending as far as the eye can see. Then he will say, do you object to anything in this? Have my scribes who keep note wronged you? He will say, no, my lord. He will ask him, do you have any excuse? He will say, no, my lord. Allah will say, on the contrary, you have with us a good deed, and you will not be wronged this day. A slip of paper will then be brought out, on which are the words, Ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. Allah will say, bring your balance. The man will say, O Lord, what is this slip of paper in comparison to these scrolls? And he will reply, you will not be wronged. The scrolls will then be put in one side of the balance, and the slip of paper in the other, and the scrolls will become light and the slip of paper heavy. For nothing could compare in weight to the name of Allah. Classed as Sahih by Sheikh Al-Albani, may Allah have mercy on him. 2. Remembrance of Allah, may he be exalted, Tasbih, Tahmid, Talil and Takbir. It was narrated from Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, two words which are light on the tongue but will weigh heavily in the balance, and a beloved to the most merciful, Subhanallahi al-Azim, Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. Glory be to Allah the Almighty, glory and praise be to Allah. It was narrated from Juwayr that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left her house one morning when he prayed Fajr, and she was in her prayer place. Then he came back after the forenoon had come, and she was still sitting there. He said, are you still as you were when I left you? She said, yes. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, after I left you I said four words three times, which if they were weighed against what you have said today, they would outweigh it. Subhanallah wa bihamdi, adada khalqihi, wa rida nafsihi, wa zinata arshihi, wa midada kalimatihi. Glory and praise be to Allah, as much as the number of his creation, as much as pleases him, as much as the weight of his throne and as much as the ink of his words. 3. Regularly reciting adhkar after the obligatory prayers. It was narrated from Abdullah ibn Amr that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, there are two deeds that a Muslim does not do regularly but he will enter paradise. They are easy but those who do them are few, saying Subhanallah 10 times after every prayer, and saying Alhamdulillah 10 times, and saying Allahu Akbar 10 times. That makes 150 on the tongue and 1,500 in the balance. And saying Allahu Akbar 34 times when going to bed, and saying Alhamdulillah 33 times, and Subhanallah 33 times. That is 100 on the tongue, and 1,000 in the balance. 4. The dhikr upon entering the markets. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever enters a marketplace and says the below dua, Allah will write for him 1,000,000 reward and erase from him 1,000,000 sin and raise him 1,000 levels. La ilaha illallahu wahdahu la sharika lahu, lahul mulku wa lahul hamdu. Yuhyi wa yumitu wa huwa hayyun la yamutu, biyadihi al-khayru wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. There is none worthy of worship in truth except Allah alone. He has no partners, he has the dominion. And for him is all the praise, he gives life and he takes life and he is the ever-living and does not die. In his hand is goodness and he is capable of all things. Going to markets is something that we do perhaps on a daily basis. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam clearly told us these places do not bring much good and are actually a source of distraction from the remembrance of Allah. That is why this beautiful hadith contains dhikr that should be said upon entering such a place. And ya subhanallah, just by saying this one dhikr upon entering such a place, you gain so much reward and get rid of so much sin. How merciful is Allah! 5. Good attitude. It was narrated from Abu Darda that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is nothing that weighs more heavily in the balance than a good attitude with people. It was narrated from Abu Darda, who said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, there is nothing that is placed in the balance that will weigh more heavily than a good attitude with people. The one who has a good attitude will attain thereby the status of one who fasts and prays. Unfortunately, we see that a lot of our brothers and sisters becomes harsh when they start practicing Islam. It should bring about a humbleness, not arrogance. It should bring about calmness and patience, not impatience. It should bring about more practice, less talk. 6. Attending a funeral until the burial is completed. It was narrated from Ubay that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever attends a funeral until the prayer has been offered for the deceased and the burial is completed will have 2 qirats of reward. And whoever attends until the prayer has been offered will have 1 qirat. By the one in whose hand is the soul of Muhammad, it will weigh more heavily in his balance than Uhud. Most of us offer the funeral prayers if we are in the masjid, but very few follow it to the graveyard and wait till the burial is completed. We should be mindful of this and know that this act can bring in great rewards and can just help tilt the scale in the right direction. On that day when the most valuable thing we will have will be our good deeds. 7. Reciting Quran. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud reported, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever recites a letter from the Book of Allah, he will receive 1 good deed as 10 good deeds like it. I do not say that Alif Lam Mim is one letter, but rather, Alif is a letter, Lam is a letter, and Mim is a letter. Even if reciting the Quran is very difficult for those of us who do not know Arabic, we should remember that the reward will be doubled. Aisha radiallahu anha reported, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the example of one who recites the Quran and he is committed to it and it is very difficult for him is that of one who receives a double reward. 8. Fasting in winter. Fasting has great rewards. In a couple of hadith we will list the virtues of fasting. Enumerated by the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, every deed of the son of Adam will be multiplied between 10 and 700 times. Allah, may he be glorified and exalted, said, except fasting. It is for me and I shall reward for it. He gives up his desires and his food for my sake. There is no servant who fasts a day in the way of Allah except that Allah will distance his face from the hellfire by a length of 70 years of travel. The Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also said, fasting in the Quran will intercede for the slave on the day of resurrection. Fasting will say, oh my Rab, I prevented him from food and desires, so accept my intercession for him. And the Quran will say, I prevented him from sleep during the night, so accept my intercession for him. He Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, and they will be allowed to intercede. This is the time of the year when we should try and observe as much fast as possible. Because the days are short and also cold, so one doesn't feel too thirsty. So another easy deed that weighs so heavily on the scale. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, said, shall I tell you about easy spoils? They said, oh Abu Huraira, what are they? Abu Huraira said, fasting in the winter. And may Allah bless Al-Hasan Al-Basri who said, how good winter is for the believer. Its night is long, so he prays in it, and its day is short, so he observes fasting in it. Come on my brothers and sisters, let us make the most of this blessing. 9. Helping others, hiding others' faults, seek knowledge. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whosoever relieves from a believer some grief pertaining to this world, Allah will relieve from him some grief pertaining to the hereafter. Whosoever alleviates the difficulties of a needy person who cannot pay his debt, Allah will alleviate his difficulties in both this world and the hereafter. Whosoever conceals the faults of a Muslim, Allah will conceal his faults in this world and the hereafter. Allah will aid a servant of his, so long as the servant aids his brother. Whosoever follows a path to seek knowledge therein, Allah will make easy for him a path to paradise. 10. Patience in seeking reward with Allah. The Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, excellent, excellent. For there are five things, how heavy they are in the balance. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah. And the death of a righteous child whose parents seek reward for their loss with Allah. Excellent, excellent, for there are five things, whoever meets Allah believing with certainty in him will enter paradise, belief in Allah, the last day, paradise, and hell, the resurrection after death, and the reckoning. This is something which we will not be able to consider as easy. But added it here firstly because if somebody had gone through this test, then this can be a consolation for them inshallah, and also considering the terrors of the Day of Judgment. This test, for those whom Allah wills, will be minor, and if they pass will have great rewards on the Day of Judgment.